Another day and another plea for information to solve the murder of Peter Wrighton, described by detectives today as one of the most brutal they've seen, but also one that can't be solved without the public's help.
It is a challenging investigation, but I think for us it's that attention to detail, being as thorough and as detailed as we can be, and that's why, you know, my appeals to the public through the media are really important. So it's vital that anybody with any information, no matter how seemingly insignificant, reports that to us. We need the public's help to solve this crime.
The 83-year-old was out walking his dogs in woods near East Harling on Saturday morning. Police are particularly appealing to trace three men seen in the area at the time who've so far not been identified, who could have vital information. The first was seen changing his shirt in the area where Mr. Wrighton's body was found. He's white in his 50s, slim and with grey hair. The second was also white with a tanned complexion, a grey or blue T-shirt and wearing what have been described as heavy-duty flip-flops. The third is also white, between 50 and 60, with a medium build and dark clothes.
Three individuals that we haven't traced. There's nothing more sinister than that. It's those three individuals that were in the area at the relevant time and could themselves have salient information. Yeah.
But they're not necessarily suspects, but they might provide
Absolutely, they've not been declared as suspects. So my appeal to them, if that description is familiar, is for them to come forward to assist us with the investigation.
It's a crime that's made headlines across the country. 83-year-old dog walker Peter Wrighton from nearby Banham stabbed to death last Saturday morning. His family paid tribute to him yesterday, describing him as a lovely, gentle husband, dad and grandfather who loved walking his dogs. He'd been married for 59 years and retired to Norfolk 30 years ago. The search for his killer is now into its sixth day, but it's a difficult investigation being in such a rural location. There's no CCTV to fall back on, no obvious motive. It means gathering every shred of evidence from the scene and getting every possible witness to come forward. Officers have been asking the public to check bins and gardens in a 5-mile radius of the crime scene to see if the killer dumped a weapon or even some clothes. They've also set up a dedicated phone line for the investigation that's known as Operation Graduate. Also this evening, police have released a picture of Peter's car, this red Skoda, and also a map of the route he took that morning, seen here in purple, going from Kenning Hall to East Harling before finishing at the street in the woods where his body was found.
It's a brutal murder. I mean, I've investigated a number of murders over my career, and it's one of the most brutal.
Neil Perry, Mustard TV, at Police Headquarters at Wyndham.